It's a cold day here in Portland. Hey everyone, my name is Nigel Bajos, and today I just wanted to give you some practical tips on how you can get more clients as a freelance filmmaker. So these tips are gonna be pretty obvious, but I think that they can be really helpful if you're just starting out and you're not really sure what you should do first. I think it's also really important to talk about this because I know that there is a lot of filmmakers out there who, you know, really wanted to make a go at the whole YouTube thing and making that work, but with all of the new stipulations for monetization and stuff like that, it's making it a little bit harder for a lot of the, you know, filmmakers who are just starting out on YouTube. So I just wanted to give you some practical tips on how you can get clients as a filmmaker and get paid doing what you love to do. So the first step that you need to take, and if you haven't done this already, I think you definitely should, is just put your best work out there. Whether it's a demo reel or just a short film that you did, or just, you know, maybe some client work that you've already done, or even if it's just a wedding video that you've done, get some of your work out there, put it on YouTube, Vimeo. Typically, a demo reel is what most people are expecting when they ask to see your work, but I've sent a lot of people my State 33 video, or one of my various other little shorts that I've done, and that's actually gotten me work. My wedding cinematography reel that I did back in 2014, that got me a lot of work because when brides want to book me, I just send them that, and that is how they know that I know what I'm doing when it comes to wedding videos. So that's definitely the first thing I would say, is put your best work out there and just make sure that if somebody asks to see your work, you can, you know, point them somewhere or send them a link. So if you're a filmmaker and you have work that you can show and you're proud of it, just put it out on YouTube or Vimeo. I put a lot of my stuff on Vimeo, and more of my like educational stuff lives here on YouTube. But I also have a website which kind of hosts both of that, which is my next point. I think that it's very, very helpful to have your own website. My website is www.nigelbajos.com, and it just has all of my best video work and my photography work that I've done there. So that's one thing that I would definitely suggest, is consider building yourself a website. Now, I've looked around a bunch and I decided to go with Squarespace. This video isn't being sponsored by Squarespace, but I looked around and Squarespace is the easiest and quite frankly the cheapest way to build a website and buy a domain all in the same spot, and it's super easy to do. I'm not a super technical person when it comes to like HTMLs and stuff like that, so I didn't really know what to expect when it came to deciding to build a website. But with Squarespace, it's insanely easy, and you can buy your domain, and it's just really easy workflow, you know, designing your website. So I would definitely say look at Squarespace. I think it's like $92 a year. So yeah, having a website really just gives you some credibility, and it just looks a lot more professional when, you know, if a client is asking to see some of your work, you can send them to your website instead of to like a YouTube page or a Vimeo page or something like that. So definitely think about building your own website. It's not the most expensive thing in the world, and it's really easy to do. And I'm definitely not the kind of person that like would know how to just build a website from scratch or buy a domain somewhere else. So if I can do it, I guarantee you can do it, and it's really not too expensive. So that's tip number two, is definitely consider building yourself a website. Now, even though I have a YouTube channel and I have a website, a lot of my clients, especially my wedding clients, have actually come from referrals from other people. So like word of mouth and through networking with people. And I think a really good tool to have is just a really simple business card. When you meet new people and they want some of your information and where they can see your work, it's way easier just handing them a business card than it is trying to write something down on a post-it note or something like that. And it kind of just makes you seem like you have yourself put together a little bit more if you have a business card. So a couple places that you can go to get your own business card is Vistaprint. I've used them a few times and they're great. But how I actually made these was through an app called Impress, and it's super easy. You can do it all through your phone. You can download it on the App Store. You can, you know, design it all through your phone, upload the pictures, and buy it through your phone. And one thing I gotta say about Impress is the customer service is really, really good. As soon as you make an order, they'll actually text you and tell you that your order was processed, and then they'll text you again when the order is shipped. So it arrived super quickly, and they're actually pretty good quality. So Impress or Vistaprint, I'm not getting paid by either of them to say this. Those are just the two services that I've used and I've really liked. So business cards definitely help. All right, so for my last tip, as I said with the business cards, networking in person, those really, really help. But another way to get yourself noticed, and it's definitely helped for me, especially with wedding gigs, is making yourself a Facebook page and an Instagram page. And those are actually gonna be really, really helpful. I haven't been really so good on the Instagram front of, you know, posting a lot of my video work on my Instagram page, but I've actually gotten a few clients from brides watching my wedding stuff on my Facebook page. So Facebook can be really helpful, especially when you're a wedding filmmaker. Because, you know, brides are typically on Facebook looking at stuff, and that's how they'll discover a filmmaker in their area. So, and I'm actually planning on doing a three-part series on how you can start off as a wedding filmmaker. I've made a few wedding films on a pretty low budget with really like inexpensive cameras. Like, I've shot a few wedding films using the Canon EOS M, believe it or not. So I'm actually gonna be doing a series on, you know, booking clients and contracts and stuff like that, to filming it, which gear you need, with the bare minimum that you can get away with, and then editing it. So if that's something that interests you, be sure to stay tuned for that. But those are my four practical tips on how you can get more clients as a freelance filmmaker. If you have any other tips that you'd like to share, be sure to leave them in the comment section below. And if you like this video, it'd be great if you hit the like button, and be sure to subscribe to my channel for more content. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, I will see you later. Bye.